In October of 2023, we embedded a pumpkin in resin, and we named him Chunk 2. But 3 days after we demolded him, Evan showed me something concerning.
Feel his butt.
Oh, it's bulging.
You can see it right there. You see that bulge? His butt is bulging out. A few days after that, we started to notice how much he was sweating.
He's like really sweating. Look at that.
It seems like he had started to rot, and we did not want that to continue, so in a panic, we threw him in the fridge. Unfortunately, once the biological decay has started, being surrounded by resin isn't enough to stop it, so we're gonna do something risky. We're gonna drill into the pumpkin and then pump it full of chemicals in an attempt to stop the rot.
This video is brought to you by Squarespace, the all-in-one platform for all your website needs.
But since all this sounds a little dangerous, messing with chemicals, we thought we would reach out to a professional chemist first.
Everyone said that we should call you, and you're the perfect expert who can answer all of our questions.
This is Nigel. You've probably seen his channel, NileRed, where he uses chemistry knowledge to do things like turn a plastic glove into hot sauce, turn cotton balls into cotton candy, and turn paint thinner into cherry soda.
The situation you guys are in, okay, I feel your pain.
We kind of get one shot.
That's the thing. It's like you put so much time and work into it, but you have one shot to do something that there's no answers to.
We gathered a list of chemicals we thought we could maybe pump inside of Chunk 2 to preserve him, and we wanted to get Nigel's thoughts. Starting with formaldehyde, how dangerous is formaldehyde?
So, it's funny. I feel like most chemicals I'll just shrug and go like, eh. I think people would be like, it's carcinogenic, it's other stuff. But I would be like, eh, there's worse stuff. Like,
I mean, technically bacon is carcinogenic, right?
Technically.
Exactly.
So. Yeah.
I think that the biggest thing you're trying to do here is, like, you obviously don't want to damage the pumpkin.
Right? Yeah.
So it's like anything that will mess its color up, you don't really want. So I think like anything oxidizing, anything like too acidic, anything too basic, nothing extreme. And I feel like you could achieve that pretty easily with just basically like saline solution with a germicide in it.
The safest and most gentle preservative that we found is phenooxynethanol, and it's in eyeshadow, sunscreen, hair color, baby wipes, soap, shaving cream, toothpaste.
The moment it's in baby wipes, you know it's pretty
mild. Hand sanitizer, it's an ultrasound gel, and you can buy it on Amazon.
Sounds like makes sense. Also, I do want to say I don't want to be blamed if this doesn't work.
No, of course. Hey, you know what?
This is all evidence to blame you.
I'm not responsible for the fate of Chunk 2.
So we have our phenoxyethanol, and we're going to make a 1% solution and pump it into Chunk 2.
But first, we need to drill two holes, one at the bottom to inject the solution, and then one at the top to let it flow out to make sure that it's fully full and there's no more air pockets. So let's get drilling.
When you tilt him, I see his juice flow and his sweat drops flow. Look
at his juice will soon no longer flow because he'll be swimming in brand new toxic juice. Masks.
Yeah, we should put on masks.
I love resin, but I don't want it to become a part of me permanently. I knew it!
It was an explosion!
Oh my gosh, it was pressurized! I knew it!
You are right! Oh god!
Oh my gosh! It's still going!
That's crazy!
That's crazy! Oh my gosh!
That is wild!
I want to smell it. There was also juice coming up.
Yeah, there was juice.
I'm scared to get too close because I don't want the juice to splash on my face.
Here, put a barrier, a liquid barrier. Not bad.
It smells like, I'm getting a light hint of pumpkin. I think I'm not close enough to get it.
Wow. That is gross. Oh, I'm smelling it. I'm smelling it.
You're smelling it?
Next is this one.
There's a whole multi-drill bit process.
Yeah, I didn't want to explain everything because it'd take too long, so I'm just going to do it.
Okay.
Now everything is primed for me to do something I've never done before, which is add an NPT tap to resin.
Evan needs to go into concentration mode. No one distract him.
Leave all the comments you want. You cannot break my focus. No matter what wild and outrageous things you're leaving in the comments, you can't. What? What did you say in the comments? I can't believe you guys. Oh my gosh. Why would you say that? I can't believe you. That is so epic. Look at that. Look at that. You see the threads being added? Isn't that so cool?
Oh, that's cool. Yeah, I see the threads in the resin.
The threads in.
The threads in the resin.
Oh, I love technology. This is called an NPT bushing. It reduces from a larger NPT size to a smaller NPT size. I want to permanently affix this into the pumpkin so that it permanently has a metal thread that won't wear out over time so that we can use it multiple times.
So we're essentially adding a metal port.
That's perfect. Now, guess what we're going to reinforce the seal with? Resin! And since there's a seal at the bottom of this, it won't flow into the pumpkin. It's just going to flow around the outside, reinforcing the seal and preventing this from rotating. There we go. Now, while that cures, let's move on to this one. How dare you? Again.
Are you the guy?
Depends on who's asking.
A friend of mine told me to ask for the Enigma.
I am who you seek.
Are you sure you want this?
Yeah, my sales have been down this month.
You will find what you seek. But first, what is your website about? This will help me guide your experience.
Haunted House Real Estate.
This will be like magic. What are your website goals?
I want to get appointments and sell products too.
Wow, this template is hauntingly beautiful. What do you think?
Wow, you really are an enigma.
You can create this and even more with today's sponsor, Squarespace.
Squarespace can help you find the perfect template.
Wait, if you did all of this with Squarespace, why did I come all the way here?
A gift from the void.
A special 10% off discount when I go to squarespace.com/Evan and Katelyn.
Yes, and with the help of Blueprint AI, you can create your own unique site too. You can even buy your domain on Squarespace or use their mini extensions to help you sell.
It kind of sounds like an all-in-one platform for all my website needs.
Exactly. Now, I must go.
You're still here.
I meant I need to go to squarespace.com/Evan and Katelyn. Oh my gosh, I'm so excited, you guys. Oh, what's finally about to happen?
It's happening. This is our water bucket.
I have to do the drain bucket over here. What do you do today? Oh, I just plumbed up my pumpkin.
Plumbed him up.
Pumped him full of chemicals. You know, just the usual annual pumpkin maintenance. Okay, there it goes. It's going.
Okay. Oh, I see it.
Oh, it's going.
Oh,
is it going in?
It's filling in.
Oh my gosh, yes. Oh my gosh. Oh, this is happening.
He's doing it. Look at his orange return.
Oh my gosh, my plan is working. It's working. Oh my gosh, I'm so happy. Oh yes.
Oh, he's becoming orange.
We're bringing our boy back.
Yes.
Bring our boy back. His transformation's almost complete. I might try angling and get some of the air bubbles out. See that? The air bubbles got sucked up. Our boy!
Oh, he's back! Oh my gosh, his little orange face! This is our first time seeing his beautiful face in resin. Look at him! Ah!
Oh, there's still some bubbles gathering. From the shaking,
right.
You see that? Oh, look at all the bubbles.
Oh, there's a lot of bubbles.
Oh, so many bubbles.
We turned them upside down and switched the pump direction. Getting even more bubbles.
Whoa, come look over here.
Huge bubble, whoa.
So much air. Oh yeah, get over there. Look at that, oh yeah.
Smack him.
Yeah, you gotta shake him around in his little cave. Prison.
Yeah, to work them out.
Yeah.
For the next 9 days, we checked on Chunk 2 each morning and he just kept producing bubbles.
There were bubbles on his face, bubbles in his tube. Would pump them away and they'd come back. Would pump again and they'd come back.
We even tried swapping the water for mineral oil to see if that helped. But the bubbles just kept coming. But after 2 weeks of pumping and bubbles, we decided to make a change. We decided to remove the tubes.
This is gonna be a little bit messy. Hold this there.
Okay.
Oh, there's air getting in. Oh my gosh.
Oh yep, there's a bunch of air getting in. I pinch.
Why is air getting sucked in? I thought you guys can't see, but we're both so oily. What? Oh, it fell out. Oh, geez.
I got on my pants.
Oh, you like those pants?
No.
Oh, you probably should have clamped it in. Air's getting in. Oh, geez.
Should have worn cute pants.
Oh my gosh, it's all over the floor.
I know. The floor is greasy. My butt is greasy.
Chunk is greasy.
Everything's greasy.
Oh, geez. Oh, we added so many bubbles.
We added so many bubbles.
Oh my gosh.
Good Lord.
Maybe we need to remove both at the same time because maybe it's negative suction from this tube. Let's remove both at the same time. Hey, oh.
No bubbles. Okay, that was it.
Okay, he's plugged.
He plugged! So now he's fully sealed again. He is once again a fully closed system. So I'm very curious to see if the bubbles stop.
And we'll check in to see how our good little boy is doing in like a few weeks.
There are like 5 or 6 bubbles up there.
It's okay. Sleep tight. After weeks of isolation in our fridge, Chunk 2 is doing okay.
He honestly is still looking great. He is looking better than when we started this little experiment.
I'm glad we did it. There's a lot of pros to this. I think the only con is that Chunk 2 is still producing bubbles. We're gonna have to burp him every now and then, just like a little baby, just like.
Yeah.
Let out your little gas, little guy. But I think it's so cool that like there's hardware embedded in here. I'm very happy we did this.
Yeah, I am too. And honestly, having to burp him every however many months is better than worrying about him exploding.
I know some of you guys are gonna be wondering about Chunk 2's younger brother, Chunk 2. Ta-da!
He is still looking great.
Who knew that an uncontrolled flash cure that got super hot and instantly cured was the way to go to preserve a pumpkin in resin cube?
He's still so orange. He's even more orange than Chunk 2, yeah. Even after Chunk 2's revitalization.
Yeah.
He's so bright. He looks amazing. And there's no bubbles and there's no bulging. I mean, there's like weird wrinkles, but we did that. He didn't do that.
Still looking just as good as the day we trapped him forever in his resin prison. But Chunk 2 is doing great now too.
Yeah, he's doing better.
Should we burp him right now?
Yeah, I mean, we could.
Let's boost him up. It's growing bigger.
Whoa.
Wait, I have an idea. Wait, that's so interesting. That's super interesting. There wasn't much pressure. Is it done?
You think so? Yeah, because there's no pressure pushing it out. Oh my gosh, I didn't expect this.
I know. I really expected it to go psh.
Yeah, like normal. Okay, we're injecting mineral oil.
Okay, look. See that? Now we're gonna have some.
Oh yeah, oh he's
bubbles.
Burping.
Oh yeah, there it is.
Yes. Look at that.
Oh my gosh, it's beautiful.
He's a bubble-free boy.
Bubble-free boy.
I can't believe that he wasn't pressurized. I'm gonna be hopeful that he'll stay this way.
Yeah, let's just end the video now where he's perfect. Look at him.
Yeah, end it on a win where he's not producing more bubbles.
Look at that. What a beautiful boy. So well behaved.
We never doubted you.
Look at that.
Yeah, you're just a little extra greasier now. We filled you up.
We might need to do this a few more times, but I'm pretty happy with how this is going.
I am too.
10 out of 10 improvement.
10 out of 10 chunks.
Hey, Katelyn.
Yes? Is something leaking?
How did you know?
No.
What's happening?
The ceiling isn't leaking again. What else could be leaking?
A pipe?
No. What else could
be... The toilet?
What else could be leaking? What else could be leaking? What else could be leaking?
Is leaking. How far did it go?
I don't think it has gone beyond the shelf.
We should have put a tray under him.
We definitely shouldn't have left for 10 days. Ooh, it's oily. Ooh, there's oil
all over your electronics. Look at all that stuff.
Ooh, okay, yeah, and he's turning white again.
Brother, no.
Brother, what is that?
How are we going to explain this when we sell the house?
We don't. We paint over it. And nobody needs to know.
We shouldn't have tried to play God.
No, we should not have. Oh, he's back to fully being ghostly. I think it all leaked out. I think it's all gone.
We're back to where we started? No!